help that old Lord in our
belief
and our faith above to call you new when you are near and seek where you are found. That when our life of faith is done in realms of clearer light, we may behold you as you are in full and endless sight.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice may be acceptable to Almighty God, our Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exalting their praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oscar, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced into eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, the God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us with confidence pray to the Father in the West, our Savior gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and saved from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ always be with you.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
Number 508, we have been told. Number 508.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please we sit down. We will have a second collection. While the collection is going on, please, I would like to present some of the religious sisters that came to our parish. Please come forward. They will introduce themselves, religious sisters from California. Please come forward. Las hermanas religiosas, eh? Sí. Monjas.
Good evening.
Good morning.
Good morning. Sorry. My name is Anita Francisco, and I'm from Gal, California, and I'm 21 years old. And we are the new sister to come in this mission. God sent us. And we are happy to be here to serve you and in this beautiful parish. And I let my sister introduce herself. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hi, good morning. My name is Alicia. I am from the Santa Maria, California. I speak little English. I'm sorry. I am very happy to be with you adding this new mission that God has given me. I am at God's service and your service. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. They are also seeking for vocation. You know, there are many young girls. Please, this is your time. Young girls from Kuzi, from this parish, you go to become reverend sisters. Eh? God is calling you this time around. So release your girls to become sisters. Eh? Yeah. In my family, my own biological sister is a reverend sister. And also my own biological brother is a reverend father. And I'm also a reverend father. My uncle is a reverend father. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our message ended, go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed Sunday.
You too, Father.
And they'll know we are Christians, number 583. We're singing verses 1 and 4, number 583.
One in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And we pray may one day be restored, and they'll know we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.
Oh, praise to the Father from whom all things come, and all praise to Christ Jesus, His only Son. And all praise to the Spirit who makes us one. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.
Have an awesome day, and to God give the glory.